Hello and welcome to Tots and Moms. My name is Kavita Prashant. Today we will try and understand why babies refuse to eat food. It may be a phase, but sometimes it is that babies continue to not eat food, find it difficult to get back to routine, find it difficult to eat anything or digest food. So this video can be really helpful for you. Few things that I would like to mention prior is until 6 months, it is important to continue to breastfeed. Post that, it is important to still continue to breastfeed till a year mandatorily along with solid foods, because breast milk or formula milk remains main food and these are just complementary. And if you can breastfeed your child till 2 years, nothing like it. So this food and baby relation can sometimes get hampered. Babies do not like to eat the same way they were having it earlier. They start hatred towards the food. They start running away from it, or they vomit, or they feel constipated. There may be certain issues that is making them refuse to eat. So let's understand things one by one. At first, let's say no to any additional fluids. Breast milk or formula milk should be only the fluid that they are taking. Otherwise, water or juices in between meals, 2-3 sips is sufficient. It is not necessary that they drink water in between, because that water requirement is taken care by breast milk or formula milk, as I said. You try drinking 1 or 2 glasses of water and then taking the same amount of meal that you used to have every day. That's not possible. So baby's small tummy will get filled with these fluids. There is a habit that some people find it good to feed juices or some drinks. Definitely avoid that. Force feeding or distraction feeding should never happen. Force feeding is when the baby is not liking it, baby is telling no, I am full, and you still continue to feed the child by distracting them by telling a story or using some gadgets and playing some videos. These are not ideal. The relation will go bad. They will start hatred towards the food. Next time you bring a bowl, they will run away. They will, because you didn't respect it when the child said no, so the baby is hating it today. So this should not happen. Quantity, that is another big thing in India that we follow. If you have this good silver bowl gifted and you are continuing to feed your child in that bowl, you mostly, or we all, you is me as well, we ensure that our baby is eating completely filled and everything is wiped by end of the time that baby is fed. So to make the baby look chubby, we do that. To ensure that baby is getting good nutrition, we do that. Or neighbor auntie will curse me, or she will say, you're not taking care of your child well, we do that. I mean, this is societal pressure that I'm talking about. Your in-laws, your parents, somebody or the other is always there to comment, give you that guilt. That will always be there. But please let us learn to respect our child's requirement. Not that every day you feel to eat the same way. You are the one who puts food into your plate and you are the one who decides how much you want to eat. Why not respect your child when the child says no? So this is very important. Repeating same food daily is another concern for 3 reasons. One is you're feeding the same texture, same flavor, same taste. Baby is getting bored and you are giving the same nutrition daily. What about other nutrition? And there is an overdosage of same single nutrition daily. For example, in South India, ragi is considered to be superfood and best first food. So if you offer ragi daily, it is taking care of iron, calcium. What about protein and other things? There's an overdosage, babies will feel constipated, and these can be concerns. Another thing is addiction to sweetened baby foods. There is a brand which has gotten so famous in India, DK's Together. Even my baby brother was fed that. And I think even I was fed that. So, and it has become an alternate name to baby food. It has sugar, it has additives, it has preservatives. So your baby's developed sweet tooth. Just try eating it once. You will feel like eating it again. A pack of Good Day, why is it sold again and again? Because it has additives. Once you feel, once you like eating it, you would not stop. I mean, 5 rupees is a small packet, even a bigger packet, you would feel like continuously eating it. That is the effect of additives. So never use that. Even it becomes difficult for babies to get adapted to regular family food. The flavor is so addictive, babies develop sweet tooth now. What about savory food? What about other texture? It becomes highly dangerous. Some things that we may not be able to observe, or and definitely babies are not able to say, are poor digestion and constipation. This can happen when we are offering same food on a regular basis. So when I said you are offering, let's go with the same example, I love that and I use it more often. If you are giving ragi on a regular basis, baby is constipated because there is no fiber in that, and so it is important to give fruits and vegetables and include fiber rich food. It can also be a reason that your child is not taking breast milk now. Just because you started solids, you have stopped breast milk, then again it can hamper digestion. Your baby is slowly getting adapted. Babies need a lot of time to get adapted to solid food. Not that they completed 6 months and then they are completely ready. Each and every baby is different. They may take a certain time to get adapted to solid food. And in India, we stay in a close circle, especially when there is a baby at home. We all go to play with the baby and all. So baby is most of the time not left down to play, crawl, move ahead. This is physical exercise. There is no activity that is being done. And on the other hand, some people worry as well. What if my baby falls? What if my baby bangs somewhere? What if my baby hurts? Or hygiene issues. So these are certain things that you don't have to worry. Baby will learn on its own. Baby's immunity will build only if you allow the baby to fight that infection. Now this is one thing. And last but not the least, let's not make a boring food routine for babies. We consider it as a chore, but for babies it is an activity. It's understandable that we are in a situation that most of them are in nuclear setup. Even in joint family, we have that guilt, we have that pressure all the time. We have so much of work, we are working, or we are at home slogging. Be it anything, we are in trouble. But will babies understand that? Babies are not yet prepared to understand that. We need to ensure that we create a healthy food habit. Then we need to portray it. We need to ensure that we eat as a family. We create that happiness and joy. We would eat variety of food, and every day is new, and every day we will feel it nice. So give that variety to your child. Not that we'll feed the child first, feed the baby first, and then come we'll watch TV and we'll have our dinner. This has to go away. Babies can sit with you. Just put few morsels of rice in front of the baby. Let baby try picking up that soft. It will not choke, or baby won't gag on rice, right? Or anything very softer, mashed banana or something. Whatever you are eating, minus salt, sugar, you can give it to baby. Let the baby try eating it. And after you are done, you can feed the baby. That's absolutely fine. Baby is enjoyed. Baby is seen a new color, new texture, new food. And baby is now happy. And now you can feed the baby. All the more, I would say, try baby-led weaning. At least try to switch to this method by 7 or 8 months, or at least by 10 months. We Indians force feed our kids till 3 and 4 years. That's dangerous. The sooner they adapt, the better their food and food and baby relation will be. So these are certain points that I wanted to bring into light, that we know but we still stay away trying such things. And they should definitely improve if it is a phase. But if it is going to continue, if your baby is not breaking this still continuing to hate food, not at all eat, then please visit doctor, because this is also necessary. Solid food is also necessary along with breast milk and or formula milk. Doctor may check for any deficiencies and advise as necessary. So I really hope that you liked this video. Do comment and tell me if you liked it, or if you have any suggestions for us. I'll be more than happy to see them. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you soon in yet another one. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.